Hi everyone, my name is Tanya. Welcome to my channel where I talk about Russian culture, everyday life, mentality, and more. I already covered premium Russian supermarket, French retailer, Ashan, and today we're here to see Spar, which is a Dutch retailer. Let me know in the comments if you're surprised to still see it in Moscow. Maybe not. What is going to be different today, instead of focusing on foreign products, we will actually see something typical for Russia, something that you'll probably will be able to find only in Russia. Are you ready? Let's start. Please don't forget to press the button like and subscribe if you want to learn more about Russian life and culture. Thanks for watching. Do you have pickled tomatoes in Russia? You can find them for 170 rubles, which is $1.70. We pickle pretty much everything. So here we have mushrooms for 160 rubles, $1.60. There are cucumbers, like pickles, and in some other places, by the way, there are like different types. So these are like pretty fresh, only a few days, and these are more salty, so it takes 6 months to a year. So we pickle everything. You know why? Because it's cold. Most of the time it's cold like 9 months a year, so in order to survive you even pickle a garlic. And if you go to a market, like local market, you can even find fermented pickles, watermelons, and apples. Let me know if it sounds crazy to you or not. Russian pryaniki, that's how it's called in English. It's translated as honey bread or sometimes ginger kufki, although it doesn't have ginger. It has honey and sometimes it has fillings. So the price for this package is 68 rubles. There's another one. Yeah, you can see it's with curry, with cinnamon. So, yeah, normally the price is around like 100 rubles, which is $1. And you can get a small one as a snack. This is a legendary Tula, pryanik. Tula is a city not far from Moscow. You can get it for 50 cents, like just less than a dollar. And there is one with a condensed milk. So it's like double Russian. So we have a lot. Like this one, more expensive. It's a new brand. It's 170 rubles. Let me show you some other like typical Russian things. The whole sukhari, like dry bread, 70 ruble. A lot of things in Russia, like from the Soviet Union and everything, were about surviving. So once it's dry bread, like this one, sushki, you can just survive for a long time and we'll keep it. So it's still really cheap. Like this package is for 35 rubles. I remember that as a kid, I was going to like the summer camp and I used to get like these types of things. It's all really cheap and it's all very traditional. We would also have this kind of things for a traditional Russian tea ceremony.
Oh, those Russians.
Honey is a big part of Russian cuisine, and I know that honey is honey. You can find it in some other places, but let me show you a Russian specialty. This is just a brand called Medalubov, like honey's lover. So this is honey souffle, like wheat honey with different berry. Here we have blueberry, raspberry. Not only berries, actually pine nuts, ginger and lime, and then mango. So the price is 263 rubles, which is approximately $2.60. Now let's take a look at seeds. You may find it also. like in some other places, and in general, let me know, like, if you have this kind of products in your countries, or it's certainly something special for Russia. So these seeds are certainly legendary, and, you know, and you can have, like, this grandma seeds. And literally, like, when I was here, I remember, like, this old lady sitting on the benches, gossiping about everyone. Like, and there are just so many associations from Russia. Yeah, I would say there's an image of a Russian, like, white trash, and you have, like, seeds. That's just like instead of like Russian chips or Russian popcorn, because back in the Soviet Union we didn't have it, so we both ate this. Now I'm going to show you one of my favorite Russian products. It's tvorog. That's what I mean is when I travel. In English, it's known as cottage cheese, and normally you'll find it in a small package. So the small ones are for approximately 70 cents, like 70 rubles, depends on the brand, but usually it's less than a dollar. Then you can find like a bigger package for 150 rubles, which is $1.50. So there are all types of tvorog. There's even this one that looks like a sausage, depends on the fat, the percentage, but yeah, this is really big and it's healthy, has a lot of protein. Next to it, another like Russian legendary product, sour cream. Again, this is probably the thing that you can find in other places, but only in Russia, as far as I know, like you add sour cream to everything, like literally, like soups, pancakes, whatever. Have you tried it, by the way? Let me know. Running. If you want to have a traditional Russian breakfast, you can get pancakes with the raspberry for 460 rubles. This one is with the cottage cheese, so it's a Russian one. So it's called pancakes, but it's more like French crepes. We eat it with everything in Russian. It's called bliny. So you can get like cheap ones, which don't look really decent to me. Normally, it's pretty easy to do it to make it yourself. I know that even David Beckham.
Oh, it's really good. Really good.
Let me just show you something also Russian. It's called chibureki, which is more like Central Asian. That's how they look like. With meat. So you see, it's like a bread pastry with the meat. Costs 190 rubles, which is $1.90, and then next week you have nuggets. Well, you know about nuggets. So in general, we have many dairy products. For instance, kefir, probably you've heard about it. I guess, I mean, you can find it in some Eastern European countries, but in Russia, there's like a bigger variety, in my opinion. You have kefir with the berries. It's fermented milk with some good bacteria. There is also ryazhinka, and like in some other places you can find like even more types of this kefir and fermented milk. That's it. Russian drinks, this one is called morse. Is basically a berry drink, so the most popular ones would be like with cranberry and sea buckthorn. I know many haven't heard of sea buckthorn, but it's pretty big in Russia. What do you think is the most Russian thing that everyone knows about? Well, of course, it's vodka. Can you imagine a Russian evening without vodka? Well, if you want to have one for Russian style, you get pickles, because we eat pickles with pretty much everything, but of course with vodka. This one is called Tsar vodka. You can get it for 400 rubles now with a discount, so $4. and pickles for 170 rubles, which is $1.70. Sounds like a perfect Russian evening to get away from stress and everything. Just forget about all the problems, all the worries in the world. All you need is a bottle of vodka. Let me know if it sounds like a good commercial or not. So far, I don't have any monetization on my YouTube channel, so I'm just practicing. Yeah. Although I'm not sure I'll get it with alcohol, but still, let me know. Do you want to try the oldest and most traditional Russian drink? It's called kvass. What do you think is inside? What do you think it's made of? Here's the picture. It's rye bread. So it's very made through a fermentation process. You know, fermentation, that's how we survive. The bottles are for 100 rubles, $1. It's considered to be the number one lemonade in Russia in summer. So because it's Russia, even lemonade will have alcohol. Less than 1%, so even kids can drink it. But if you want to have like a Russian type of beer, it actually tastes like beer. Yeah, that's why I started talking about beer. I found one which can bring back you to the USSR. Haven't seen this package, but I feel like people have more nostalgia these days. You can get it for 75 rubles, which is apparently a good price compared to the rest. I know that in many countries you can find daily Finnish product, but I want to show you like the Russian specialty. Dumplings. Russian dumplings are considered to be like the main Russian dish. Here we have like a Soviet package, which is the cheapest one now for $2. The rack is approximately $3 or 300 rubles. They say Siberian. So normally it's a mix of beef and pork. So this is like a Siberian collection because they're known to be from Siberia or Ural region. In any case, this is something that Russian known for, and no, normally Russian men don't know how to cook, but you know, once they learn how to boil dumplings, they start bragging about being like the cook. So, in this video, I tried to focus on something special and typical for Russia. Let me know if you liked anything. If you have this kind of products in your countries, maybe something sounded interesting and surprising to you. Of course, that's not it. There's more to see. For instance, there's like chocolate cheese, and this brand exists from 1934. So, like, good old Soviet times. And there's another one, which is also very Russian. I told you, like, we add pickles to everything, whatever thing it is, even if it's, like, absolutely unmatchable. In the comments, please write what you'd like to see in supermarkets, in, I don't know, like, markets, if you're tired of supermarkets. And if you like this video, please don't forget to press the button like, subscribe, write comments. And if you want to support my work, if you want me to do more videos, you can make contributions on Buy Me Coffee, Patreon, PayPal, and other platforms. The links are in the description and in the comments. Thanks for watching. See you next time.